to work for her that summer. Teenage kid so far from home. She was a lonely widow woman, hell-bent to make it on her own. We were 1,000 miles from nowhere. Wheat fields as far as I could see. Both needing something from each other, not knowing yet what that might be. She came to me one evening, hot cup of coffee and a smile, in a dress that I was certain she hadn't worn in quite a while. There was a difference in her laughter, there was a softness in her eyes, and on the air there was a hunger even a boy could recognize. She had the need to feel the thunder, to chase the lightning from the sky, watch a storm with all its wonders raging in her lover's eyes. She had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind out where only dreams had been, burning both ends of the night. That summer wind was all around us, nothing between us but the night. When I told her that I'd never, she softly whispered, "That's alright." Then I watched her hands of leather turn to velvet in touch. There's never been another summer where I have ever learned so much. We had the need to feel the thunder, to chase the lightning from the sky, watch the storm with all its wonder raging in each other's eyes. We had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind out where only dreams had been, burning both ends of the night. I often think about that summer, the sweat, the moonlight, and the lakes. I have rarely held another when I haven't seen her face. And every time I pass a wheat field, watch her dancing in the wind. Although I know it isn't real, I just can't help but feel her hungry arms again. We have a need to feel the thunder, chase the lightning from the sky, watch a storm with all its wonder raging in each other's eyes. We had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind now where only dreams had been, burning both ends. Rushing headlong in the wind out where only dreams had been, burning both ends of the night.